can provoke conversations, highlight social, political, environmental issues, and has always been a powerful platform to convey messages to the masses. Originally vandalism, used to mark territorial boundaries, today street art is a tool for urban beautification. Artists travel between countries, spread their design, gain mass followings, and work commercially. They are no longer constantly at risk of being handcuffed by police, falling from a roof, or under the wheels of a subway train. Street art became commercialized. Many artists got bored of repetitive street art festivals and looked for deep meaning in their work, sometimes in unusual places. One of the most interesting projects I had an opportunity to co-organize was in Chernobyl. We know about the disaster that happened in 1986. The nuclear power plant in Chernobyl exploded, releasing 400 times more radioactive matter than bombing of Hiroshima. Igor Kostin, a Ukrainian photographer, took some of the first pictures within hours after it exploded. For the next 20 years, he persistently investigated its effects on mankind and the environment. He died of illness related to this exposure. We wanted to acknowledge the 30th anniversary of the world's nuclear disaster by creating a painting from a photograph taken by Igor Kostin, giving a tribute also to the photographer. The mural was created inside a technical construction. This is still a very restricted area, and the level of radiation is higher than normal. The artist was able to use only a ladder, and he created this mural for only one day. After that, some other artists asked us about an opportunity to paint in this area, because it's cool. But it's not cool. It is a scary place. We did it only once to commemorate the tragedy responsible for taking so many lives. In eastern Ukraine, where a war is taking place, we created another unusual project. In 2014, pro-Russian separatists captured several towns in Ukraine. There we created the project. Even though the frontline city is right next to the active war zone, people still remain and live among the conflict. We invited an artist who wanted those people to think about something other than the war, at least for a moment. He visited a local school and he chose one teacher because of the kindness in her eyes. While working, they heard hundreds of shots every day. The signs of bullets can be seen on the building where they were painting. The bulletproof vests and helmets were worn by the artists and photographers. The teacher's husband got injured during the fighting in 2014. They were not able to afford his medical treatment, but after the mural was painted, a journalist wrote about her story in an article. The attention helped her to fundraise for her husband's recovery. This mural was named one of the most thoughtful murals of 2016, according to UK's street art blog Graffiti Street. One of the main goals of this project was to attract attention to Ukraine. People die, but not enough for international news. Many people do not even know what is going on. At the same time, we wanted to show that Ukrainians are still alive. We work hard and do amazing things. We have created a row of murals inspired by the recent situation in Ukraine. It would be too direct to show objects like weapons and soldiers, but it's always possible to express ideas through the abstract. For example, a mural named Instability that shows a ballerina dancing on a bomb is criticizing the failure of coexistence between people and Earth. Another mural depicts a woman hugging a white figure. This person is not present here physically, but the sense of presence is here. This is a story about missing someone, like those soldiers who are fighting to liberate the east of Ukraine right now. Similarly, an artist created a gift named From Russia with Love, an interpretation of the love-hate relationship between Russia and Ukraine. Finally, among our the most significant works we created last year is unofficially the tallest mural in Europe so far. The 26-story mural, in an abstract way, incorporates the Ukrainian word Volya, which means liberty. We quickly made Kiev one of the leading cities in street art. Murals are now part of guided tours, along with architectural and historical landmarks. They attract international journalists photographers, street art lovers. But all this began right here in Gainesville, where my first project was organized. When I just moved here 4 years ago, I lived right across from the 34th Street graffiti wall. I was able to photograph new paintings in the form of classical graffiti and UI greetings, which is a good way of communication, but there were no murals. The walls downtown were bare. It was weird for me that in the city with one of the biggest universities in the United States and so many young people, a relevant contemporary art form had not developed. So I wrote a proposal, found walls, got permission, sought for sponsors, convinced artists, and the city of Gainesville helped me to produce it. Of course, it wasn't so easy, but then murals by internationally recognized artists were created, as well as 10 murals by local artists. I wanted to bring something new to this city. More colors, more events, more opportunities for artists. I wasn't sure if it's possible at that moment, but I decided to try. Most people love the new look of downtown Gainesville. They have a reason to do a walk, invite their friends. Plenty of publications appeared all around the world in street art news. The more known an artist is, the more followers he has, the more attention he can bring. We also have very meaningful works in Gainesville, like the one that is dedicated to the problem of gentrification and displacement, or another that can be named controversial, that depicts a beautiful cityscape and a weird world across of it. Many people love to take selfies in front of it, but those who know this is a chemical formula of methamphetamine would want to paint it over. Why did artists title it this way? He wanted us to ask this question, and possibly to think about the global problem. Often, a thoughtful piece can be painted over. In Jacksonville, Florida, where I recently worked as a consultant on a project, a mural named Capital Control that depicted a security camera and was painted on a bank existed for just a few days. Street art creates a space for dialogues between artists, viewers, and building owners. Actually, people in Jacksonville really liked this mural before it was buffed, but the managers of the bank were sure their customers would feel uncomfortable with Big Brother watching them. The most recent project I've done in Gainesville was supported only by neighbors and ordinary people. No sponsors, no organizations, no city involvement. We all volunteered, from artists to organizers, with the main goal to make this neighborhood beautiful. Up to 10 artworks were created within just 1 month, using only one scissor lift, and with a very small budget. An internationally recognized artist created a mural for us that features the portrait of Wilhelmina Johnson, a prominent local educator, to celebrate the remarkable achievements of the Black community in our town. And a very important mural we created with the mission of raising awareness and stimulating dialogue about global ocean environmental issues. This action also attracted some attention to our town with plenty of publications once again. I believe public art is the perfect mediator between artists and audiences to inspire action. Each of us can contribute, if not through giving permission to paint on your property, providing sponsorship, or engaging artists, but simply stop by and try to understand what it means. Thank you.